Hi, my name's Ellen. I am Christian's aunt, and he's asked me to say a little something about my mom, Jamie. And I just want to say that she was a hardworking mom, funny, had a sense of humor, had the loudest laugh, gave me advice all the time, helped me make decisions, let me make my own, whether they were right or wrong. Told me the truth, whether I wanted to hear it or not. She was a good mom, and I miss her very much. And my kids miss her. As a grandma, that's where she shined. She loved being a grandma. She liked being a grandma more than she liked being a mom, I think. She loved her grandkids, and she spoiled them, and she let us all know that they were the favorites. And for you, Chris, she was proud of you, and she was excited to see where you were going. So I just want anybody who misses her to remember her the way she wanted to be remembered, which was happy and healthy, and to know that she's now with us in spirit. And for anybody that didn't get to know her, know that they missed out on knowing a great woman.
My mom, Jamie Patrice Drake, was born on October 2nd, 1958. She was born to my grandma and grandpa, Ellen Drake and Walter Drake. When my mom was 16 years old, her dad died of lung cancer, so she was raised by my grandma, who was a single mom. She was 19 years old when she had my first sister, Selena, and she was 22 when she had me. My mom raised us as a single mom for most of her life until she met my stepdad, who also helped raise us. My mom was very strict with us, and at times too strict, so we weren't really allowed to do much. But as she got older, she let my brothers and other sister pretty much do what they wanted. Her first grandson was Christian, which she loved dearly and always had a special place in her heart because that was her first grandson. When she was in her 50s, she was diagnosed with breast cancer and stage 1 breast cancer, and she was able to get through that, but re-diagnosed when she was in her late 50s, and she battled that for 3 years before passing away. So my mom was a really good mom. She was, like I said, really strict, so loving mom, but I guess it helped made me succeed in life because she was so hard on me that it made drive me further in life to do better. So she always taught me not to rely on anybody, to always make sure I supported Christian on my own and did things without the help of anybody. So I really thank my mom for that. I love the Pittsburgh Steelers because her family was from Pennsylvania, even though my mom was born in Southern California. She also was a diehard Dodger fan because her dad was a Dodger fan from the time she was a little girl. I remember in the 80s watching the Dodgers with my mom when they won the World Series. She loved the Dodgers, win or lose, and loved the Steelers no matter what. She wasn't a big fan of basketball or anything else, but baseball and football she was a real big fan of.
Well, when it comes to my mother-in-law, Jamie, I have a few things to say about her. She was a very funny lady. She had that funny laugh that I always liked. She was very stern and always checked you on your baloney, that she would say. So you can never get anything over on her because she'll call you out on it, because she was a real person and real real with everything she said. She was very caring and she was very loving, especially towards me, her son-in-law. You know, when my parents died, she was there for me and took over as my mother figure in my life, and I'll never forget that, and I will always be indebted to her for that. And she always loved when I said Roxanne and would sing for her, so that was always something that made her laugh, and I always try to make her laugh. But I loved her very much, and I'm very happy that I was here in her life as long as I was. Jamie, you're the best. I love you.
Growing up, my mom was pretty serious, strict, and stern. But she was a sweetheart. I remember getting in trouble at school wasn't the best idea because as soon as the principal called, you knew it wasn't going to be okay. And we would walk home from school. She'd be standing at the front door, giving you this mean look, this certain look that she had on her face, and it was pretty scary. My mom's always been a hard person, but I understand why she was hard on all of us. She wanted us to be better. She wanted us to do better, become successful. And she taught us with great respect, and I appreciate her for that. And our whole family appreciates her for that. And she's genuinely a nice, kind person. And she is the strongest woman I know, strongest person I know, and will always be. For her to battle through her sickness and take care of all of us and support us and push her sickness aside just to be there for us and be at my football games and support and watch and take care of us all. And she's just the strongest woman I know, and we all miss her, and she means a lot to me. She means a lot to our family, and she was such a nice person. And all my friends, they'd see her and they would think she was mean just because she had this look on her. She was very serious. But as soon as they got to know her, man, they thought otherwise. They thought she was the kindest woman ever. And every time my friends would spend the night, she'd always make breakfast for them every single morning. And they'd be in love with my mom. And my mom always treated my friends like if they were her kids. And we all appreciate that. And my friends appreciate that. And she will be missed, and she will never be forgotten. Love you, Mom.
She was the most wholehearted person that was in my life that impacted me the most. And with her death, it left a lot of, like, when I was younger, I went through a lot of things, and my grandma was the biggest supporter, otherwise than my mom, that would help me through everything. I made sure that I was okay and talked to me about anything that was going on. And she always knew that I'd come talk to her about it, and she'd be honest and be wholehearted about everything that she was talking about. And even though she never went to any of my games, she would always ask me how I was doing or if I ever needed anything, how everything was going with sports or anything they had in life. She loved herself some of her homemade spaghetti that took her hours to make. That was probably her favorite thing, other than Mexican food. She would always clown on me about wearing ripped jeans. For my birthday a few years ago, she even bought me patches to cover it. And every time after that I seen her, she would ask me where my patches were and how if my mom never had enough money to buy me like brand new clothes without holes or anything. She would always clown at me about anything. We had never had a dull moment in our life with her. She always brought joy and happiness to me, and especially to my little cousins that came into our life 2 years ago. She had the biggest laugh ever that you'd always hear no matter what, where you were in the house or anywhere. Through the last 2 weeks of her living, I got a voicemail from her because I was at practice and I couldn't answer the phone. It was the last real time I got to talk to her. She told me that she loved me, and then no matter what I was going through, and she was so proud of me. I was going to get into 11 schools and to see what I was going to do in life and become a nurse. That was just going to be the biggest impact in my life, was her saying that. The last thing she told me was that she loved me, but it was through a voicemail.
I wanna be alone with you. Does that make sense? I wanna steal your soul and hide you in my treasure chest. I don't know to do with your kiss on my neck. I don't. feels right, so stay safe. Yeah, you feel right, so stay a sec. Let me crawl inside your veins. I'll build a wall, give you a ball and chain. It's not like me to be so mean, you're all I